lot of different guys made plays, and I think, you know, first half we were able to jump up on them. And we're disappointed, obviously, how we came out in the third quarter. You know, offensively, you know, we didn't finish in the red zone, and defensively, you know, had some drives out. We gave them some things, but overall, you know, it was important to get a win today, and we did that. And I thought a lot of guys, you know, made significant plays and did significant things to help to it. So feels good. And enjoy today, and then move forward tomorrow.
What impressed you the most about your team today?
I thought we had good energy, and you know, thought we made some plays. You know, and able to get up, and that helps. You know, so kind of just I like the, you know, the approach they had, and able to carry it out and make it productive.
You go into a game like this thinking, this might be an opportunity to go, you know, 47 points, 500 some yards. I mean, is it a surprise that you got that much? Or do you guys think you'd have to?
I'm always surprised when you get a first down. I mean, it's true. I mean, you never want to take anything for granted. And I've always been like that. And, you know, you think if you do what you can do, but to just think that you never go into a game thinking, boy, this is what we're going to do. You know, I think you got to, I think you do that, you disrespect the game. You know, and so, you know, going to every game, you know, confident of the plan, but, you know, you're also appreciative when players execute it. That's why I'm not trying to be, you know, smart aleck. I mean, you are appreciative of it, and it doesn't just happen. And that's why you've never been one to expect anything.
Is it sort of a sign maybe of how much the offense has progressed? I mean, that drive there at the end of the half, I mean, obviously you guys had a breakdown earlier in the season in the Silver situation, and this time it was boom, 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 and, you know, on the touchdown pass, Tino did not hesitate. It was second option and touchdown.
Yeah, no, it was good. And you know, you do hope that we're, you know, improving and learning from situations, you know, and it was big, you know, and so that was good. A lot of guys did a lot of things, you know, made some plays. And, you know, a lot of guys that afforded, you know, our playmakers to make plays. And that part we like. You know, I like the way the guys approach the work week, and it's fun to then be able to go out and see them play on game day. And, I think in some areas we are getting better, but I think there's other areas where we truly do got to, you know, keep grinding and get better.
This week, the couple of running games have been consistent. A little more pleased with what you saw today.
Yeah, I mean, it was Pedard. I thought Ray ran really well, and you know, I thought he hit some things, and you know, hopefully, you know, he just keeps getting more comfortable and better. And I thought Russell had some runs, and I think that energizes your team, and you know, that doesn't happen if you guys aren't throwing it around up front, and so. Appreciate that, but yeah, I thought it was a little bit better, and you know, we should be getting better.
Do you have any updates on TJ and Sleeper and Hubie?
No, you know, Hubie, I know, I remember when he came off and looked like he was holding something tough, haven't gotten a report there. TJ, you know, he kind of aggravated something, you know, in the pregame, you know, that's why he didn't go. Who else?
Sleep.
You know, it's a lower leg thing, so we're going to find out. Really don't know anything definitive from any of those guys.
How's Dan Mason, and how do you think he played today?
Yeah, I thought he did some, you know, I thought it was a heck of a play he made, you know, in that fourth down. You know, I thought there's a couple other plays that, you know, the one is the first drive, I think, in the third quarter, you know, we jump off sides, you know. But I think he was productive. You know, I think he was around the ball. You know, all these guys, you know, you appreciate what they do and making plays. And yet, I think you got to hold them to a high, high standard. And I know there's some plays Dan knows it, you know, that he can play better. And I think you're cheating if you don't expect guys to play their best all the time. I don't know. I thought that whether it's, you know, a couple of guys. Yeah, here it is. I mean, me and four of the players trying to figure out what he hurt, you know. And I haven't talked to Rob in after the game, course of the game. So I'm not sure that the stomach or what it was.
Coach, you had 11 goals,
lost
105 yards. Is there anything in particular you feel like any reasons that was penalized as much as it were today?
No, you know, I thought we made some poor decisions, you know, in the kick game. You know, we're the one, you know, and I think we gave guys, you know, they gave them an opportunity. You know, we had the one line on the block behind the ball. We had a procedure, a couple of procedures. I know JP had one, Dan had one. You know, we had just, I think it's, you know, we got to maintain the focus. And that's an area that, you know, that's hard to win games doing that. You know, I thought a couple other ones, you know, become judgment calls. And that's the game, but that's not very good stat.
Coach, how do you feel about Lafayette Pitts coming as a player?
I think, you know, he was good, and I think his one play changed him. I mean, that was, you know, that, and then Ray followed up with a heck of a run, and it was a two-play drive. And I thought the team needed that, you know, and I think Lafayette's a good enough player where he can put that on him, that, you know, you got to be able to impact the game. I think the work he's been putting in, and I think he's growing, you know, and at times I forget, you know, he is a young player, but you appreciate that, and I think, you know, we can expect a lot out of him. I mean, I think that's what we need, because he could be very good.
Seems like they got some third downs on you in the second half. How will you address that going forward?
Well, I mean, you look at it and see what caused it, and then, you know, I think some were, you know, situations, you know, I don't think, you know, in the third quarter we tackled particularly well. You know, we had a couple penalties that created it. You know, I don't think it was just one thing, but we've got to address all those and, you know, get off the field. You know, we had, you know, they had a long field, and you know, we didn't take advantage of that field position. You know, I thought, you know, some of those penalties really did change the field. We could have had a big, you know, short field and get blocked in the back. You know, Cam had a great return, and that was nullified. So, you know, there's a lot of areas we can get better.
How do you evaluate Shane Hale's segment?
You know, it seemed like Shane did some good things. You know, be able to talk more specifically about it. You know, obviously after watching the film, I know Anoki felt that he was doing some good things, and you know, Shane should. You know, he's a senior and has played a lot of ball, and he should step in. We shouldn't miss
it. Well, it's been about a year since Ray got hurt. I know he's been acting, you know, he's obviously been playing since the start of the season, but in the sense, is he still getting stronger? I mean, is he still sort of getting back to maybe where he, physically, where he maybe thought he was by when he got hurt?
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't with him, you know, before. I thought today he cut it loose a little bit, and to me that is one of the signs that a guy is trusting it. You know, I like, he was calling for the ball. I liked his whole approach. You know, and so I would think that, you know, that is transferring over, that he is feeling, you know, he's feeling better. And I also think he, you know, he knows what we needed. And we needed him to be good. And our good players have to be good. And we appreciate that.